Hey everyone, welcome to Chalchitra Talks. Mera naam Samidha hai. Today I want to talk about and recommend to you a jazz artist that you should definitely check out if you're into jazz music and more of the old school classic instrumental jazz. And also if you're not into jazz but you enjoy listening to piano instrumental music. The artist I want to talk about is called Ryo Fukui, and he's a Japanese jazz musician. He's one of the first artists that I was listening to when I started exploring the jazz genre. And even though I was getting more attracted towards experimental and contemporary jazz bands and artists, Ryo Fukui is one artist through which I've got introduced to a lot of the other classic old school jazz works and work of legends such as Bill Evans, John Coltrane, and Miles Davis. And I have been introduced to Bill Evans' work through Ryo Fukui because Ryo Fukui takes a lot of inspiration from this particular piano player. And I've been loving exploring Bill Evans' work so much, and it's just so beautiful to listen to. One big reason why I really admire and respect Ryo Fukui is because he started learning how to play the piano at the age of 22. And if you were to listen to his music and his piano playing skills, the conception that you have to start learning how to play the piano when you're young or when you're small, and only then you can play piano at such a level, that conception just went away. And it's just so inspiring to hear what he plays and that he started learning how to play that only in his 20s. So I want to start by recommending some songs from his first album called Scenery. This album was released in 1976 and it was almost 7 years after he started learning how to play the piano. This entire album does not have only his originals but also has a lot of the covers and his retakes that he has done of some classic jazz songs, and it's kind of his homage to the inspiration he draws from these jazz legends. The first song I want to recommend is an original of Ryo Fukui, and it's called Early Summer. I love this song for its beautiful piano intro, which goes on for about 3 minutes, and you can hear him basically gliding his fingers through the piano, and this is something that any really amazing piano artist would know how to do, and any very well accomplished piano artist would know, but I keep coming back to the fact that he started learning only in his 20s, so it's really commendable. Like, his piano playing skills here are on full display. This song is almost an 11 minutes long song, and a lot of Ryo Fukui's work, his covers as well as his originals, are quite long, but it doesn't feel that way to me because I personally enjoy listening to instrumental music a lot, especially piano instrumental. And in this particular song too, as the song goes on, the piano keeps building more and more. It becomes more complicated, becomes more intricate, and at the same time, overall, it becomes very groovy. The next song that I want to recommend from this album is called Autumn Leaves, and it's a cover of a very famous jazz song by the same name. The original song was composed by Joseph Kozma, Johnny Mercer, and Jax Prevert. Before listening to Ryo Fukui's work, I had never heard this original song as well, and I got introduced to it because of Fukui. And the original song is also so beautiful. It has vocals in it, but also if you listen to Fukui's version, it's again amazing, like the way he has adapted it into an entirely instrumental piece, and it's such a soulful piece to listen to. So if you have not already heard the original song, I would highly recommend that you listen to the original and then also listen to Fukui's version of it. Another thing that I noticed was that some parts of this song, their structure is quite similar to the song A Lovely Night from the movie La La Land's soundtrack. And I personally love La La Land's soundtrack so much because it's, again, it has that classical jazz piano music, and it's just so amazing. Like, all the songs from this movie are amazing, and I've watched it so many times. I recently rewatched it again, and then I listened to Ryo Fukui's music. I'd been listening to it since the past few days, and I recently only realized the similarity in this song and quite a few other songs too. So maybe La La Land's music composer took some inspiration from not only Fukui, because Fukui himself took inspiration from these classic jazz legends, but I couldn't find anything concrete that there was a relation. although but I couldn't help but notice the similarity, at least in this particular song. Next, I want to recommend some songs from Fikui's second album called Mellow Dream. This album was released in 1977, and this album as a whole is such a soulful and I think quintessentially jazz album. It's a very good entry point for anyone who's looking to get into such sort of jazz music. From this album, the first song that I want to recommend is called Mellow Dream, and it's the title track of the album, and here again the piano takes the center stage. At about 1 minute 20 seconds into the song, there's a particular piano riff that comes in, and it's I think my favorite part of the song. It's so beautiful, and throughout the song such amazing piano riffs have been included. One more thing that I really like about this song is that the drums come in pretty late, because the piano piano takes the center stage, piano kind of establishes over the entire song, but when the drums come in and then the bass comes in, this song becomes something else on its own, and it's still such a beautiful song to listen to. The second song that I want to recommend from this album is called Barren Potato Blues, and this is one of the most playful pieces by Fukui. In this song, it's not just the piano but also the bass that is like the main element for me. The bass complements the piano so well, and it sounds so playful, and it has all the classic jazz elements that are very easy to recognize if you're into jazz music. But at the same time, it doesn't sound very repetitive or mundane. So anyone who likes the very old school quintessential jazz, the jazz which you cannot help but nod your head to, you will definitely like this song. So if you like these particular songs and want to explore more by Ryu Fukui, some more songs definitely worth checking out are Horizon, I Want to Talk About You, It Could Happen to You, and Scenery. And definitely if you like all of these songs, you should also check out the entire album called Mellow Dream. So these were all my recommendations for Ryu Fukui, and I've been personally loving exploring jazz so much, as I've mentioned so many times already in like my previous videos. And every time I explore or find a new jazz artist that I like, it's amazing to me that how much variety this particular genre has. I also personally love piano instrumental music so much, and it's my go-to choice of music to listen to when I'm working or I want to relax or I want to take a walk. And Ryu Fukui's music is perfect here because it's fairly simple in instrumentation. He's mostly played with a 3-member band, and still it's just so soothing and so beautiful to listen to. So I would love to know what you think about Ryu Fukui's works and these particular songs, and I'll be back next week with another recommendation.